up, everyone? Getting to get back into some more Koudelka here. So let me flip that screen on over here. Boop, boop. Unmute the game. There we go. Lovely. So how's everyone doing tonight? Good, I hope. Court's not cooperating. There, over there. Perfect. Check out this one. Nope. How is that game? It looked pretty cool. I just haven't picked it up yet. You know, it's like a Soulsborne kind of game.
So this is Elaine.
Yes. She's the one I had the psychic vision of. Do you doubt it?
Indeed.
Good. Let's begin.
It has been a long time indeed, Mr. O'Flaherty.
Oh, Elaine, is that really you?
Yes, it is. It is such a pity that we meet again, and I can only present myself to you in this form. This is the woman that responded to my voice, is it not? Thank you for doing this for someone like myself.
Elaine, I haven't yet come to terms. Please tell me how this happened to you.
Of course I will explain. James, 18 years ago, I was murdered by some thieves that broke into my home. I was helpless. Both Patrick and Ogden were out on business. There was nothing that anyone could do.
I will not accept this. This should not have happened.
Yes. Patrick responded the same exact way. He could not accept my death. He spent years and years perfecting his craft in wizardry and tried everything in his power to bring me back to life.
Resurrecting the dead? Is this for real? Hey, we're not talking about Frankenstein here.
Frankenstein?
That novel written about 100 years ago?
He was taking it very seriously. And he had found the key to actually make it happen.
The immigrant document.
Yes. With Ogden's assistance and the powers from ancient druids, he held a resurrection ceremony in this monastery.
But something went wrong, didn't it?
Of course something
he
went wrong.
He only resurrected my physical body. As you can see, my soul is still doomed to roaming the universe. Forever separated from my body. And the terrifying thing is that my body was resurrected as a heartless monster.
Monster.
Although the monster may look like me, it is not me. Mr. O'Flaherty, please turn my body into ashes with your power.
Ashes? If I do that, we won't be able to bring you back to life.
Mr. O'Flaherty, I was robbed of my life by those thieves, and I could hate them as mortal enemies. Choose to think that my death was preordained by the Lord. Please, do not mourn my death. It was wrong for Patrick to try to resurrect me, to undo the work of God. Please, do not be sad. Death is at the heart of God's reasoning. I urge you to destroy my body. Its existence defies the wise providence of heaven. It mustn't exist in this world.
Okay, wait. Spooky lady.
Elaine! God! Curse! What a cruel world! I gave everything for your happiness! happiness in that.
Exactly.
What am I left with? I have no meaning in my life. Dad! What have I been doing with my life? Elaine! Elaine!
His voice actor putting some work in there. That was very good. See a portrait of a young woman. Sounds good. Now that I killed that bot, yes, yeah, I should be able to get through that door now. Indeed. See a scroll? The direction of a dragon. Above the dragon, it reads Hestia. Remember correctly, that means hearth in Greek. Oh, that's not a clue. There's a fire burning in the hearth. I don't think I have anything I can burn in the hearth, do I? Ask. This. Shotgun shells? Yes, please. You see a skill. When you step on it, it points to 45 kilograms. That's neat. Clayman got upgraded. Let's see if it likes getting hit with a mace. Not bad. Goodbye, Hollow Knight. Might be too close. Yep, it was. The old poke. Okay. See, if it survived that, this thing's tanky as heck. Magic. Two in mind, and let's get more health. J-ring. Only I knew what it actually did. That's equipped to somebody. Get rid of that fist weapon. See what our new accessory does. That's just a fire's earring. And it's somehow weaker. So I can get some acid. I can probably get a weapon. Pistol. Probably, now that I can finally hold that acid, let's pick some stuff up. What? Come on. Why can't I interact with that? She's looking like right at it. Containing a ladder that goes in the ground. No. Don't want to go underground yet. I want this item that it refuses to give me. And Patrick's memo. Let's read that, shall we? Note written by Patrick monitoring his weight over a period of several weeks. According to it, Patrick weighed more or less 70 kilograms. Helpful. I don't know why it's like refusing to pick this item up. Oh well. Set down the ladder. And I guess we decided to walk into a Resident Evil game. The green herb on the ground. Oh, Flare leveled up. Nice. Goodbye, hand. Nice. Point and look. Some more mind. Another jeering. Okay. Now let's take a look at that. See. It's any better than anything I already got. Nope. Sure. Yeah, we'll find it. Panacea. Nice. Very nice. Open. Looks like it's been designed to open using a trick mechanism of some sort. Counterweight attached to it. So counterweight, you can bounce, change the bounce and scale. Straight on Patrick's memo. Oh wait, so I weigh 45. This would be 25. Simple math here was the correct answer. Okay, there we go. Oh, hey, look, a dead guy. Man, this limited inventory is really, really dragging here. The old tinderbox. I'm assuming that's a key item. It is indeed. Metal box with a latchable lid used to carry matches. Contains several matches. This is Elaine's body. Something in the main building. Still won't let me pick that up. That's so weird. There it goes. Alright, back to the main church building. Just gotta trek the whole way back to that acid place. That acid tank. Dabby Pierre. He's a fancy ghost. Him up. Oh, thanks for the heal. We killed the guy at least, so. Something. Actually, I bet I can use the acid to free up that that sword. Yeah, let's try to fight the gargoyle. Okay, we're gonna temp save here. Feeling he's going to be very strong. Little does he know that Edward is a kung fu master. Oh, jeez. Well, that's a problem. It seems in my hubris, I have died. Rip. Alright, well, that was... Well, now I know not to fight that again. I tried to fight the gargoyle. And he one-shot my entire party. I did 46 damage to him. Yeah, we're gonna leave him alone for now. Come on, downstairs. There you go. back. So this is underside of the chapel, the monastery, and it's some acid. Ghost children, so we took care of them. A sword. See how that does. But guys, goodbye, spaghetti monster. We obtained acid. Here. Let's see something. Let's see if I have a feeling I can use this acid on that sword. Smelly bada bath. Very nice. Got a badge of some sort. Let's check that out. Sacknoth. Alright, so the acid was not the answer. Let's head back into the to Patrick's Manor. Ooh, 5 damage. Ouch. Let's see what level 2 megalith does. I'll just one-shot him. That works too. Another Galahad, so that's cool. ladder. There's anything else in the main building for me to look at. Little kitty. Oh, I'm sorry, little cat, but your time has come. Koudelka level up. Look for her. Agility. Another cat's eye. To interact with at this point. It's in the main building. This way? No, nothing that way. This has to be something. I'm genuinely lost here. other side again, maybe. I don't know. This juts out at me, too, is, like, weird, but I don't think it's anything. That just leads back to this. Oh, do we get another Roger cutscene? I hope so.
I know it's here. I saw it here. I put it here. What? Have you come round to see me again?
I want you to look at this.
Research journal.
I want you to tell us whether what's written there can actually happen or not.
Well, let me see. Yes, I see. Oh, that's right. Resurrecting the dead. Ooh. A cauldron. The Branwyn tales, indeed. Yes. It is most likely that the events detailed here did take place.
Just as I thought. But that's so frightening that
if personally, I have not attempted it. I am certain that the emigre document contained accounts of secret rituals conducted to resurrect the dead. But as you can tell from reading this, it involves complicated preparatory work. I had given up discerning the impossibility of using the psychic powers necessary to create such an immense psychic platform. Moreover, I never expected that people would attempt to challenge such a feat.
The journals say that the physical body was resurrected, but not the soul.
Absolutely. The ancients held the secret to life in the palm of their hands. But they could never come close to touching the secrets of the soul. They resurrected the dead in order to use their physical bodies as a workforce, thus building the great civilization we oft-times speak of. In fact, we would not be far off if we called them puppeteers. Exploiting the human body as an object.
If so, then we...
Yes, resurrecting the dead and restoring them to life as it was before death is impossible.
Then how do you return the resurrected body once again to Earth?
That is a very complicated question, since it already defies universal logic.
Please.
It is no easy task.
Tell me how. It's Woody Lane, God rest her soul, wanted.
Right. It is not absolutely impossible. But I would need to call forth the sacred powers in order to complete such a feat. Oh, yes. I know that the arm of Daniel Scotius, the man who built this monastery,
is... That's convenient.
...stored in a stone statue on the ground. If we throw that into a cauldron, we will successfully destroy the roots of the Tree of Life. Oh, after that, I haven't a clue whether to call forth the energies of fire or entrust the task to water. Oh, it is so complicated.
Fire. Or water.
What are we going to do?
Oh, Heavenly Father, bless our souls and bring forth an end to this suffering. Oh.
Okay. So we already have Daniel's arm. So, I guess we just gotta choose fire or water.
What do you guys think? Fire or water? Fire? Okay. Burn it all. That's a big debuff. Why am I missing all my attacks now? Goodbye, ghost. What? Hit him with another tornado. Hit damage. For some reason, I'm thinking gun scale physical attack damage. Now the key question is, where's the cauldron? Guessing back in his lab. That looks like a cauldron, I guess. Is this coming out of it? Hold on. Stop. Get back down. Love this battle theme. So good. I pretty good damage for a physical attack there. Then Koudelka just comes over and shows him up like nothing. James hits for 1,000, Koudelka hits for 12,000. Pop temp save. Some more Roman nuts over here, so we're gonna go grab those. Who doesn't love four revives? See six dolls, it looks like. The lower four dolls can be moved. Happens? Okay. So we got a puzzle. Try to brute force this. Because that's how you solve a puzzle for real. I think I see it. Oh, no, I guess not. Okay. There's probably a clue here, but I'm too lazy to look for it. Okay, I'm full on pistol ammo. Oh, there you go. Unlocked door. Ooh, shotgun shells. It's weird where some of these scenes transition sometimes. It's kind of annoying. It's Glassman 2. The glassening. You got spikes? I've got spikes. Mine hit harder. More health is always good, and more dex. There's probably nothing on either side of this. It's just weird rooms you can look. Oh, prove me wrong. Oh, what's this then? Okay, so that's the boss room. Let's go check out this other room. Shadows, but you can't see well. Life drinker. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Let's take a look at that. Well, it's pretty good. Life drinker. A necromantic blade gives its user great power in battle at the cost of his or her life energy. Oh, cool. That may be good with the Edward. Or maybe we won't use it. Who knows? Let's go take care of our boss. Oh, that's a thing. Go big here. Oh, that's good to know. It's strong to fire. At least I'm close that I haven't done any damage to it yet, really. See how water works. Oh, don't tell me it absorbs magic. That's gonna be annoying. Okay, wait. It really doesn't look good. Try one more spell on it, see if I'm correct. Yep, okay, so it absorbs magic. That's great. Yeah, it just whacked him twice in the face with its, like, weird tentacle arm. But apparently it absorbs all magic, so that's cool. Yeah, it's absorbed fire, water, and wind. Try one more. See if it likes stones. Yep, cool. Try shooting it, see if that does anything. Nope, miss.
Come on. This boss is annoying. Change weapons here. Oh, of course. Of course. That's good. I shouldn't be able to reflect an item, so. Try a different weapon, see if that does any better. Now it's absorbing physical attacks. Oh, okay. I think I get how this works now. I think I have to alternate how I hit him. Oh, Rip James. Yet again. Okay, cool. She gave him a little smack, a little slap in the face. No? Okay. This boss is very confusing.
Man, it really does not like James. No, I really can't blame it. What is this boss? Like, sometimes magic hits it, sometimes it absorbs it. Wish there was like a scan function so I could check an enemy. Okay, I'm looking this boss up. This thing's making me mad. Apostle. Okay, so let's call the Apostle. Okay, so it has like two phases. Yeah, so does it, when it gyrates, it's immune to, like, everything. When it's not gyrating, I can attack it. Which, it's weird, to be honest, the battle would have, you know, said anything about that. Well, I'm gonna heal it again, so that's cool. This is very aggravating. Why would you design a boss like this and then not mention it does this? Let's try this again. Still yeah, so when it does that weird body shudder, that's when you can't attack it. So you just sit here and wait. Thank you. to heal her magic up very soon. Battle is so much fun. Don't you start jittering again. Oh, you piece of shit. Of course, I can't escape. This is a very aggravating boss fight. On. I get a turn. It's not being a spaz. Nope. Time to heal it up another, like, 1,000 points. Just kill it now, please. That'd be a really cool game. Oh, thank goodness. That was awful. Throw those potions away. Oh man, that was awful. But yeah, with that, I'm going to go take a quick break here, and I will be right back. Okay, and we're back. Sorry, I forgot I had my mic on, yeah, my mic on, my mic. Well, I had my audio through my phone here, because that's how I'm watching the stream. I don't need to save. Yeah, we gained about 6 levels between all 3 characters, so that's pretty good stuff.
This must be the temple.
There's no way! If I put a bullet through it, it wouldn't budge. What are we gonna do?
How ironic to have made it this far and not have access to the temple.
Koudelka, Edward, you both must go now. It is my friend that is apparently responsible for this disturbance, and therefore I am partially responsible for this trouble. I have no intention of asking for your sympathy, and I'm in no position to plead for your help. So from this point forward, I can manage on my own.
Don't kid yourself. We didn't come along just for your sake.
No, Koudelka, you should go back now. It'll be far too dangerous.
Edward, you're the one who should go home. You were not meant for this world. Granted, you are a good fighter, having had plenty of experience, and I won't deny the fact that you have the killer instinct either. But when all is said and done, you are an average Joe. I am not. I was meant to exist in this realm. It's the only place I can carve out an existence for myself.
Quit lecturing me! I want no part of a lukewarm existence filled with regret. No. My way is to not worry about consequences, and to do whatever it is I want to do. Chance means nothing to me. Life's a gamble, and once you place your bet, you'd better play to win, or else you end up dead.
Edward, you really are ridiculous.
That's what they tell me.
Do as you like.
That I will.
Oh, suddenly when you feel like it, you decide when you can and cannot open doors?
Yeah, right.
Wait, there's a way. Remember when we were searching Patrick's mansion? There was various chemicals around. It may take some time, but I think I can combine the chemicals to make nitroglycerin.
Nitroglycerin?
That's great! We're talking powerful explosives here!
For this door, I think we'll need a full flask. Indeed, if I drop the flask before I return, I'll be knocking on Heaven's door in a flash.
I go, and it is done. The bell invites me.
Hear it not, Duncan, for it is a knell that summons thee to heaven or hell.
Yeah, it's pretty accurate. Ooh, so we've made it to disc 4. Over. We'll find out. So I guess right now our goal is to head back to the lab. Stuff. See if there's anything there. All right, let's make some dynamite.
I'm going to begin my work. Can you two wait for me here?
What happened to the girl, Melanie?
She was gone the next morning. She left with practically everything in the room.
You don't have much luck with women, do you?
Well, you know what they say. The cleanest breakup is when a woman runs out on you.
What a statement. Oh, but you're lucky. I mean, to have so many people to kid around with.
Me? I'm all alone. I've been all alone all my life.
What about your childhood?
Yes, I did have a childhood. I was born in a small town in Wales, right off the banks of the Tilesian River. It was a small gypsy town.
Gypsy?
That's right, gypsy. And we didn't call ourselves gypsy. We called ourselves Rom. See, a true gypsy is born under the blue sky and is destined to die under the same blue sky. It's gypsy law.
So then I guess you plan on dying underneath the blue skies?
Mm-mm. Every gypsy is given a name at birth. My given name was Slato.
Slato?
Mm-hmm.
It's got a strange resonance to that name. What does it mean?
I can't tell you.
That too must be part of the law.
The law it is.
You know, ever since I met you, enigmatic, mysterious glint in your eyes. It must be the gypsy in you. A glance from thy soul's searching eye can raise with hope, depress with fear.
Byron again?
Yeah.
You must really like him, don't you?
Yes. So I feel as though we're birds of a feather.
Then he must be self-obsessed as well.
I'd rather be classified as a romantic. My father was a strict man. He couldn't forgive his son for failing academically. He blamed my failure on the time I wasted inventing adventures, dreaming of a utopian landscape. I was brought up to believe that dreams, the power of the imagination, as well as all the things I loved as a child, were useless, a complete waste of time. It was as if he was telling me I was useless. And then again...
You're not useless, Edward.
Maybe just that.
You're my stabby boy.
Well, I think I was probably born too late. By the time I was 15, everything there was to be done had already been done. The Western territories were colonized. The jungles had been explored. There was no wilderness for me to wander
exactly.
into. No jungles for me to cut my way through. I guess that's how I ended up roaming the country. And granted, I picked a few fights along the way, played with fire, gambled on my life a few times. But none of that comes close to the truth I'm searching for. I yearn for something far greater. I can't quite explain myself.
He's searching for the five-piece McNugget meal at McDonald's.
For some intangible treasure of sorts. Koudelka, I envy you. You have psychic powers that few are blessed with. Being born a gypsy, you can choose to live how you wish.
And who gave you the right to act as if you figured me out? Do you have any idea how I was raised? You make me laugh. Adventures. Please, you haven't the slightest clue. Do you have any idea how much pain my psychic powers have brought me? My father died when I was only a child. I predicted the exact time, place, and ending of my father's life. Imagine that, predicting your own father's death. No, I was cursed as a child, being given powers not meant for a child. And my mother? Oh, she was so frightened and so full of hatred for me. She tried to kill me with her very hands. The gypsy elders got together and decided to excommunicate me. I was only 9 then. Do you have any idea how a 9-year-old child survives without the help of a living soul? Treasures, you must be joking. Have you ever cried and begged for your next meal? Did you ever sell your body, seeking shelter from the frigid night air? I used to be just like Charlotte. When she cried and said, "No one has ever loved me." Oh, her words cut straight through me. It was me she was talking about. Just like her, I wished that everybody would die and harbored a hatred for all mankind. But you see, Charlotte has made her peace and gone to heaven. Me, I'm still alive and still all alone. No one has ever lent a helping hand. No one!
Koudelka, you?
I am not as free as you make me out to be. I am a poor, dirty, ignorant woman who threw her gypsy pride to the dogs in order to live. But you see, even someone like me can do good. Because with my powers, I can help ease the pain of others. That's when I feel good about living. I don't need to be loved. I just want my life to have some meaning. And just want someone to tell me they need me. You. No way will you ever understand.
Well, that was very sad.
It's done. It's completed.
Okay, so I didn't need the acid for that. Cool. They sure did. Well, I mean, I'm carrying a small distillery in my inventory, so I mean, that makes sense. Go ahead, hit the save point before we go blow up a door. Good damage, Edward. Little guy's, he's grooving. Oh, goodbye, little buddy. You're grooving in heaven now. Yes, everybody's leveling up. Yeah, let's go explode a door. Yeah, you probably want to. Probably want to stand further back than they did there. Nitroglycerin is some pretty nasty stuff. That's the cauldron. Interesting. Upstairs here. Piano. Excuse me, people's secret pain and light. I can only push each key once. There we go. Nothing like brute forcing puzzles. To get gusty. Yeah, it's a fire bastard sword. It's pretty decent. Elixirs. Good stuff. Back down. Let's see what that organ did. Tree of life has stopped. Beyond the stained glass, you see a sheer cliff rising from the ocean. Oh, here we go. It's this way. So that's probably what the piano opened up. Yep. Okay. It did say go down, so. I'm sure he's fine. He's just sleeping.
Poor Patrick. Hey, what are you doing? What's that? No, don't!
I'm not asking for your help. This is my problem. None of you need to die with me here.
Oh, you're not dying here, James.
sure? Let's proceed. Saint Daniel Scotius, protect us from these evil spirits and grant us inner strength. Amen. Were created and born out of dust. Now go quietly and return to thy maker.
Yeah, that'll show you. We got some pissed off tentacles. It's not that bad. By the way, the animation looks kind of like they're throwing leaves at me. Strong. Edward coming in and just cleaning up the place here. Ooh, wow. I don't know if you picked the right place to go there, Tentacle. Sword broke. Okay, I have another one. Oh, that was a boss fight. A bunch of idols. I have no idea what those do. I have no idea what those are. Luck. Oh, they must be one-time use items. Yep. Nothing like free stat ups, though. They're always awesome. Action. Weapon. Go back to my Galahad. Spiky boop. Good stuff. Man, I don't know why he is like so weak to physical attacks. Six K damage. Her vitality. Nothing for James. Okay. We can have a water spear, there you go. Normally you wouldn't want to run towards the top of a burning building, but each their own. Oh, hey, look, it's Patrick. He's fine. See, I told you guys.
Well, thanks for moving up so this hits both of you. Weapons again. The thing is very low accuracy. There we go, that's a good hit. I'd be more impressed if I wasn't doing like 5 times that damage. See, now I'm more impressed. All right, goodbye, Patrick's Vines. Those. make Koudelka a little faster, so that'll be nice. Feeling of uneasiness steals over you as you realize you no longer have the pendant. Plant. Previously steady, it suddenly picks up pace until it feels as though the plant will explode. Jeez. What pendant? Okay. So we got the bad ending. I don't remember a pendant. Yeah, I don't remember that at all. Glycerin. Where do I get that at? Alright, I guess I'll go check the fountain here. But it was cool, we got a face melted, so that was cool. That was a pretty cool FMV though. So remember kids, make sure you wear your jewelry when fighting the unholy birth of a mad scientist. Exactly. Now, is it the, like, big fountain? Get out of here. No point fighting these birds. There we go. Okay. Gonna toss an item. We have now obtained the pendant. I can go this way. I appreciate it. Yes, yeah, there's some weird things with this game. Exactly. It's like, how are you supposed to know that? Same with the Apostle boss fight. It's like, yeah, they show you that it undulates, but they don't, you know, say that it means anything. So it's like, how am I supposed to know what that means other than you're just making the boss fight cinematic or something? Alright, Edward, just, level 60. Whew. That's rough. Maybe what I'll do is set up a save. And we'll do that as a challenge fight. Because I'm pretty sure we're going to beat the game tonight. Just judging from, where we're at. Just sit and take a day and grind everything out. Save. Save. Watch this cool blow up the door cutscene again.
Exactly. There will be less face melt this time.
It's amazing.
I've completely forgotten what order I pushed those keys in, so it'll be fun to fight that again. I really like this battle theme. It really does. You did good, James. You stood there. Really contributed to that battle. Hey, and he's the one who leveled up. Just what you get. Some physical stat boosts. Glaive and a bastard sword. Wasn't it? Yeah, you'd think just doing this, I would remember what I wrote. There we go. I think essentially what those runes are for is to, like, kind of deal with the cauldron. At least that's how I'm processing it in my brain. That makes sense. That looked like a box of some sort, but it's not.
Hey, what are you doing? What's that? No, don't!
I'm not exactly asking for your help. This is my problem. None of you need to die with me here.
Pop a temp save. Exactly. I shall call upon the power of fire. Yes.
Let's proceed. Saint Daniel Scotius, protect us from these evil spirits and grant us inner strength. Amen. Created and born out of dust. Now go quietly and return to thy maker.
Time to fight some vines again. Doing some light gardening here. Big damage there, 9 damage. See if Edward can clean up like last time. Yep, seems like it. Thanks.
but he'll level up. Cat's eye and girdle potions. We'll continue just hitting the menu button for all of eternity. For Rumble in the Jungle Part 2. Nice, that was a good hit. Ooh, ow. Yeah, you'll have to shoot me those in Discord. I'd be interested to see those. Patrick's Vine's being very aggressive this battle. It's very physical. Go. Keep Edward nice and topped up. Guess he's had enough of my shit. These jams proves useful there. The final blow. Two piety idols. Fine by me. That gives her a bunch more magic. Get the statue a good pressure wash here. I was like seeing that very intricate animation. Zero damage. sure I equip everybody with some weapons. I've obtained the rod. Big jumps in stats for her. Give Koudelka the rod, make her more of a mage than she already is. Pop our save here. Let's see if we can avoid some face melt this time. Our magic jewelry blocked her Kamehameha. That'll show her. Yep. Yeah, that one bullet stopped there, guys. Absolutely. Yeah, this is definitely an experience. Yeah, I know we just hit 10 o'clock, but we're going to keep going. Exactly. How did we glitch? I think the game froze. It's okay. Yeah, we froze. Oh, we did. I saved right before I entered the cutscene there. I thought I had. I didn't think the game would freeze on me, though. We won't watch the cutscene again, because one time's enough with that. Yeah, it's weird they did that. It hasn't done that yet. Oh, we get some new battle music now. It kind of sounds like a jungle area in like a traditional RPG. Am I supposed to just run from this? Oh, maybe not. She's also a velociraptor. Nice, we've done about 5K to her so far. Thank you. Well, time to use poison breath again. One of these times he will hit her. She's grooving. Good heal, good heal. Goodbye, Lane. Nice. Surprised nobody leveled up from that, though. Man, she's persistent. So yeah, I haven't really actually used this at all, but if you use the fortifying spells on an enemy, it actually acts as a debuff. Hacker now instead of using magic on her. Well, time to find out. Okay. Koudelka will be support this time, I guess. Four damage. I love it. She's gonna run away because she's scared. Yeah, exactly. There's no escape, Spider Lady. Jeez, 5,600. It's more health than my characters even have at max. I have another bastard. It's not as strong as the Bastard Sword, but it's still pretty good. Debuff her a little bit. Check. Although I think she's pretty close to being dead, so. Thank you. There we go. Goodbye again, Elaine. A lot of bells. Oh, now she's truly becoming a spider. Song. Yeah, she knows who the real threat is. See how you like fire. God. Okay, she's strong. I may die here. It looks like I was probably supposed to.
Dear God, is this my fault? Do you blame me? Are you punishing me now because the path to my faith was tainted? I accept my fate. If it is your wish, then I accept my fate.
Ending two.
He who has an ear, let him hear. If anyone is to go into captivity he will go. If anyone is to be killed with the sword he will be killed. I am what I am. I am content with my lot. I have always loved you, Elaine.
Don't be silly. There must be something we can do.
We'll be fine. Trust me.
Oh, hey, it's a boy.
In these crazy times, young people push themselves too much.
Ah, the sun came out. I prefer it a little hazier, though. Goodbye. We'll probably never see each other again.
Hey, your nickname. Zlato? What does it mean? I haven't even asked you yet. Will you tell me?
It means treasure.
Oh, that's rich. I'll remember that. Treasure.
Is it okay, child, for you not to follow him?
Yeah, it's okay. I have a feeling that someday, somewhere, we'll meet again.
Weird credit music here. cool. Sackcloth, that's the same name as that holy sword you couldn't get. The big reason I'm letting these run right now, I'm not sure if there's a after credits cutscene. No, in my luck, there probably isn't, but we'll find out together. Possibly. I'm guessing Obeater. Okay. That's I'll maybe save that for the challenge run when we go fight the gargoyle too. Because I think I need to level up a little bit before I can beat her. Because boy, does she hit hard. Alright, so ending two is the canonical ending. That's cool. Yeah, we're going for about 3.5 hours now, so I think we'll call it there for tonight. So let me flip the switch over here to the ending screen. Thank you for taking this journey with me here. We definitely will be back to Koudelka. And because we'll do some challenge runs, we'll save that for a separate stream on its own. I do plan on streaming some other cool stuff. Thinking Parasite Eve was probably be next. So hopefully you guys are excited for that. I've never played through Parasite Eve at all. I've only played a little bit of it. So I'm excited to play it and beat the game. So stay tuned for that. I'll be back tomorrow on YouTube. We'll be continuing our Resident Evil 4 run through, finishing up Separate Ways, and do some Assignment Ada. But until then, folks, I have more content coming. Have a good evening.